So Binance, the 16th of September, released their crypto cards with a up to 7% cashback. Man, this is absolutely absurd. I better switch from my crypto.com card to the Binance card because this cashback is insane and you're only getting 5% on crypto.com. Let's see what they have. Oh, what is this? 8% back on all purchases instantly on the crypto.com card. This was released the 17th of September, so one day after Binance actually launched their cards. So you absolutely have to love the war between Binance and crypto.com. As you know on my channel, I have been talking about this for, well, since the inception of my channel. That was one of the first topics that I talked about. And honestly, it's probably a good idea to own both of these cards, but we are going to do a deep dive. We are going to look at the difference between these two cards because there are actually some which you need to be aware of if you are a crypto.com holder or a Binance BNB coin holder. Then stick around because we start right now. Welcome back, guys. This is Cristiano bringing you this Binance versus crypto.com video. So first off, can we surpass 13,000 subscribers? That would be absolutely massive. And also, it's becoming very obvious that we need a Discord server for this community. I posted this video just an hour ago, and I mean, I'm getting so many questions right here. We need a forum to discuss these types of things. We need a forum to help each other out and to take advantage of this massive opportunity, this massive financial opportunity that is the cryptocurrency market. So if you would like me to create a Discord server for all of us to hang out in, well, then let me know down in the comment section. But right now, we are jumping into the war between Binance and crypto.com. And before we talk about Swipe SXP, let's look at what Binance actually announced. So Binance Visa cards are now available in Europe. Get up to 7% cashback. And to celebrate our big roll-up in Europe, Binance card is offering the highest cashback rate anywhere. So this was kind of like a peek towards crypto.com in my opinion. Why? Because that is what they do. They peek each other always. So how does this work? Does this work exactly like the crypto.com card? Well, not entirely. Because when you use your Binance Visa card, you don't have to worry about fees from our side. We charge zero subscription or maintenance fees, and transactions made in euros are free of transaction charges. Third-party fees may apply. So I'm going to get back to this specific part here in a bit because this is actually a big deal. But let's move on. To make the deal even sweeter, for every purchase that you make with the Binance Visa card, we are offering up to 7% cashback, the highest rate available in the market today. Well, Not right now, in fact, I have to say. But when you spend using your Binance Visa card, it converts your crypto funds into your local currency automatically, allowing you to spend at 60 million locations around the world seamlessly. So this is a big difference with the crypto.com card. On the crypto.com card, you actually have to sell your crypto, you transfer the money to your card wallet, and then it's just sitting there. It's just regular fiat. But here you're actually being, the crypto is being converted as you actually buy with the card. That could be a pro or a con. For me personally, I've said it multiple times, I prefer to actually sell my crypto and then have it in fiat in the wallet instead of always, you know, regularly seeing these small amounts being converted back and forth. It's just harder to keep track of, in my opinion. So how do we get a 7% cashback on your fee-free Binance card? So aside from being able to link your crypto to real-world fiat spending, the Binance Visa card also offers distinct advantages such as zero transaction fees, maintenance fees or subscription fees, and the most generous cashback rates in the market. The Binance Visa card offers cashback for every purchase that you make with the card. The cashback percentage will depend on your card level, which is then based on the amount of BNB held in your Binance account. So this is actually where it gets interesting, because to get the 7% cashback, you need to hold 6,000 BNB within the last 30 days. So how much is that currently? Well, we bring out the old calculator. With today's price of, well, not actually 30, but something more like $27 for each BNB, take that times 6,000. And you need to spend, or you need to hold $162,000 worth of BNB in order to get the 7% cashback. So that's quite a large sum. But what you do get is that you can hold your BNB on any of the accounts. You can hold it in the spot wallet, you can hold it in the savings account, As they say here, for example, you have 200 BNB in your spot wallet, 2000 BNB in your futures wallet, and 20,000 BNB in your launch pool account. We add all your BNB balances to your Binance account, regardless of where you use it, to determine your cashback rate. No need to worry about arbitrary rules or restrictions. In this case, you will have 22,200 BNB in total. We grant you 7% cashback rate. So this is also a peek towards crypto.com. Arbitrary rules or restrictions. As you know, you can stake on the DeFi platform on crypto.com. You can stake in the app. You can stake on the wallet. There's a million different ways to actually stake on crypto.com, but you don't have those rules here. You have 6,000 BNB on any of these accounts. Well, then you are going to get 7%. So that is cool. But once we actually dive further in, well, first off, I'm going to say this is also a big pro when it comes to the launch pool, because as you can see here, you are getting about 51% launch pool APY if you're holding BNB. So as you can see, you're farming Bella, you're farming Wing using BNB. Now, this was actually more like 70% a couple of days ago. I actually did the calculation myself. I watched how much Bella I had gotten. I calculated the APY. And it was actually something similar, like 70%, but now it's going down because more and more people are buying. You know, that's just the way this market works. So just remember that the BNB you need to hold for your card, you can actually utilize that in the launch pool as well, and you're getting an APY on that. So these are the countries that are supported currently. So you have Europe, and you also have Guadeloupe and some other countries right here. Now, I want to talk about some things here. So first off, your Binance virtual card will be issued upon a successful order, but please note that the physical cards are under manufacturing time periods at the moment and will not be delivered for 6 to 8 weeks. So if you buy the cards, if you apply for the card today, you don't really know when you are going to get the card. I mean, this is just an estimation, in my opinion. I think that this could take anywhere from 8 weeks to, 3-4 months, actually. We just don't know. So they say it is zero fee, right? But it's actually not. You're going to pay a fee if you pay in any other currency than euro. So if you go to the Swipe page, and Swipe is the provider of the actual cards, you are going to get about 2% for anything that you are buying that is not in euro. So if you live in, well, let's go back to the countries. Where were they? Here we are. These are the countries that they are shipping to. So if you live in the United Kingdom, you're obviously paying in pounds. Well, you're going to get a 2% fee on every transaction. As far as I'm aware, that's just how I understand it. So that's not really that good. So it means if you live in any country that is not using euro, those 7%, they are actually going to become more like 5%. So right now they have updated the cards on crypto.com. So as you can see here, 8% on the a million CRO card, 5% on the $100,000 CRO card. So that means that if you actually live in any other country that is not using euro, it's probably better to use this card, because this card, 100,000 CRO, how much is that? That's $16,000, and you're getting the same, kind of the same benefits and the same cashback. Now, if you want to get the 8% cashback, well, you take this times 10, obviously, and you are going to pay about the same as you are doing with the Binance card on the highest tier, you know, the 6,000 BNB. Of course, you have one further incentive with the launch pool, but you don't really know how high these yields are going to be on the launch pool moving forward, because they are going to continue going down. But yes, today we announced the cashback for crypto.com card have been increased to 8% for Obsidian and 5% for Frosted Rose Gold and Icy Whites. No annual or monthly fees, no fee ATM withdrawals, no foreign transaction fees, with 100% rebate for Spotify, Netflix, Amazon Prime, and airport lounge access for selected card tiers. So as you can see here, it's the same as before, but they have added another 3% here, another 1% here, to to not be worse than Binance, actually. So looking at the chart, well, crypto.com are pretty close to their previous all-time high. I mean, it's not really that much going on right now. We have perhaps some bit of a, well, we have a downwards trending channel. Let's see if we can break out of this. But, you know, the performance of crypto.com has been nothing less than phenomenal. I mean, from the bottom, there's gone up by 750%. That's like a 8.5x, completely insane. And looking at BNB, well, there's not really that much to say about it. We have somewhat of a, I mean, perhaps something like that. This is going to act as a line of support. As you can see right here, this is acting as support right now, in fact. But let's talk about Swipe SXP, because I have to admit, I did have higher hopes for SXP and their price action. So we are currently at $1.45, which is kind of low. I mean, given everything that they have been putting out, they have had some massive announcements. They recently got somewhat of a kind of like a banking license in the United States, actually. And well, they are able to offer a bank account, a checking account. And also they are about to launch the cards in the United States. But, you know, the price has not been doing that well. I mean, currently we are sitting at, what was it, 1.45. And we are dangerously close to the July levels, which is completely absurd. I am going to do a separate video on Swipe SXP. So if you would like me to do that, just let me know down in the comment section. But for now, let's jump into how to get $1,500 for free on Uniswap. If you have ever used Uniswap, then you are probably able to claim $1,500 for free. So let's jump into it and I'll see you right there.